Hey, Mr. Frequency, KP68 here. I'm finally getting around to doing a video for you on the oscilloscope and how RF is displayed on it. All right, so to begin with, just using a little setup here, I'm using my Galaxy DX2547, could be on channel 20 AM. Just using my little A-static 600 watt meter. Doesn't have to be too crazy accurate for this demonstration. I'm gonna be using a 2-watt carrier, a little 10 watt scale, 2-watt carrier. Get back to the scope. Just want to show you how RF is displayed here. So what we're going to do here, and back this down, let me show you what the dead carrier looks like. Right there. Perfect little sine wave. Up here, there's a frequency on my transmitter. You can tell it's off. It's time for a tune on this sucker. So anyhow, there's a carrier right there. So what's going on here? This signal is going by, I'm just going to say 27 megahertz, 27 million cycles per second. But now you're going to say, well, we're going to have only a 1,000 hertz signal going in there. Well, how can we display two at the same time? So what we do, well, here, I'll show you what it looks like here. See, we can't really examine too much how it's, the audio is affecting the carrier. And so what we do here, we're going to take this, how it's displayed, like I said, this is only for display purposes, has no bearing on the signal itself, just how it's displayed. We're going to condense this more, 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 more. We're going to keep on going there till we reach a point where we can now watch how the audio is affecting the carrier. This right here, it's called your envelope. You hear about PEP, peak envelope power. Well, this is your envelope right there. I'm going to pause that. This right here is your envelope. Alright, I'm pause that. Okay, now, when I key this, like I said, the oscilloscope just sees a voltage coming in. It sees a voltage coming, senses the voltage, and displays it on the screen. Alright, so this is keyed up. Like I said, this is the condensed. This is that carrier condensed. So we can see the audio. Alright, this is zero output right here. Zero output. When I key up, the oscilloscope senses the voltage and displays it. Now when I modulate this, when this voltage is doubled, here to here, this doubled, that corresponds to a quadruple output of my RF power. Right now my watt meter says 2 watts. Now we're going to take this, I'm going to modulate this up to 100%. There's quadrupling of this carrier. Up to here is 8 watts. Alright, so I'm going to put a 1 kilohertz tone into there. Watt meter's climbing. Right there is 8 watts, about 8 watts. I wish I had two cameras or more hands, but unfortunately I can't. I just have to take my word for it. But so up to here, that was 8 watts. 2 times 4, quadrupling of the power. We have 100% modulation. So as you can see right here, also pay attention to this. This is where our reference was, our day carrier. What goes up must come down. You get the exact same up as you do down. Symmetrical, same on both sides. Alright, I'm going to unpause this. Now I'm going to take it up to 4 watts. We're going to do 50% modulation. Alright, I'm going to pause that. Okay, right there, I took it up to 4 watts. We had that 2 watt carrier. 4 watts, halfway. 50% modulation. And like I said before, remember our reference dead carrier was right there. And it went up this that far, and it went down the exact same distance, symmetrical. These are your positive peaks, these are your negative peaks. Alright, I'm going to unfreeze this. Now I'm going to take it up past 100% and watch what happens. Alright, I'm going to go up. Right there is 10 watts, about 10 watts of power. I'm going to freeze that. Alright, like I said before, what goes up must come down. But now, see what happens here. Something's got to give. You can see we went above 100% modulation here, but we can't go any further down here. So what happens is it shuts off. This is no output. This is zero. It's squashed down, or we pinched that carrier. That right there is distortion. Now, I've heard some radios out there that don't sound so bad. You know, I guess in moderation, I guess they sound all right, but nonetheless, that's distortion right there. So anyhow, that's why I've talked to you before about that one box up, one box down thing. But it's just a quick, easy reference in looking over and seeing your modulation level. So remember, zero oscilloscope sees a voltage. When the oscilloscope sees that voltage double, that corresponds to a quadrupling in your RF output. So right now, that's a 2-watt carrier, one box up, 100% modulation. I'll do it one more time. That is 8 watts. About 8 watts right there. See, 100% modulation, that's at its limits. Any more, that carries just about starting to pinch. Well, this is going to lead to my next video. I'm going to go over the REA station monitor. It's pretty cool. But then we'll get into asymmetrical modulation and see what goes on there. Another thing to note here, I'm going to unpause this. I'm going to take this back up past 100%. Alright, there are some mods out there. You hear the negative peak compression. That's what that's referring to. There are people have different diode configurations where it'll fill in that. It won't be quite so pinched, but that mod isn't quite positive peak expansion. At least that's what I call it, of the modulator board. So, in a nutshell, that's how modulation is viewed and measured on the oscilloscope. I hope I explained it somewhat half-decent, but anyhow, like I said, this is going to lead in my next video. I'll try to do it as soon as possible. I'll talk to you later, Mr. Frequency KP68, and I'm back out.